Wonderful time to be in God's presence again today. Today is the day two of our revival, which is themed the Destiny Maker. Yesterday was the day one where we had Pastor John C. Iyanu and where he talked about the Destiny Maker. It was a wonderful time out yesterday. I really enjoyed myself, and I'm very sure my co-host enjoyed herself as well. So before we go into talking about how yesterday's service went, I'd like to introduce myself. I still remain at Jumobia Building, and I have here with me.
I still remain Oluwadam Nola Kayode, your co-host.
Okay, so it's nice having you on this platform
nice
once again.
You too, yes.
Okay, so yesterday was very powerful. We had Pastor Johnson Iyanu from the singing aspect to the prayer section to the word of God.
Yes.
It was a wonderful.
Everything was wonderful.
Damela, I would like to ask you, what was your take home for yesterday?
Okay, my take home was, you know, there was a point he was talking about, you know, the way he broke down what destiny is, what it entails. You know, there was a place he talked about. He said, our destiny is what God has predestined us to be.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's like God, it's God's plan for our life. So God has predestined a good destiny. There's a good destiny attached to each and every one of us. You know, the way he explained it, and he gave examples of people in the Bible, you know, that were one time, he talked about Rahab, the prostitute. Yes, and our destiny, you know, came forth later. So God's plan for us is a good one.
Okay, I also love the fact where he also talked about our destiny. For your destiny to speak, you need a vehicle, and he gave some examples in the Bible of characters that can actually make your destiny to speak.
Sweet
talking
up.
About kindness, talking about humility, talking about hostility, learning how to welcome people. He talked about so many things, and I can assure you that today's edition is going to be a wonderful one. I can't wait to unveil our minister. For today.
Yes, and you know one thing, Pastor Johnson, what I noticed, he said something yesterday. He said he knows today will be greater than yesterday. That word was very powerful.
And that's an assurance that today's edition is going to be a wonderful one. Viewers all over the world, you can't afford to blink your eyes off today's telecast. It's going to be a wonderful one. We have our man of God already on seat. He's going to be coming up very soon. Should I unveil him?
No.
Okay, viewers all over the world, stay calm, stay tuned to our telecast. We'll be right back. Thank you, and God bless you.
God bless you. Things he has done. You're welcome back from the short break, and I'm happy to introduce to you that our guest minister for today is already on ground. Like I am sure he's fully loaded. Yes, and he has a lot for us today. So I'm going to welcome to you Pastor Malachi Nnanna. Good evening, sir. You're welcome, sir.
Evening.
Yes, sir.
It's my pleasure.
Yes, sir. Sir, can we meet you, sir? I want you to introduce yourself to viewers all over the world.
I'm Pastor Malachi Nnanna by name, a senior pastor of Divine Intervention Outreach.
Okay, thank you very much, sir, Pastor Malachi. You're welcome once again. I believe this is not your first time of coming to Salvation Church, right, sir?
Yes.
Okay, so how does it feel coming to Salvation? What's the feeling like coming to Salvation whenever you come to Salvation to come minister? How is it feeling like, sir?
I feel great. is a work of God. And whenever a man of God is called to come and minister, he's honored. So, and we have to accept it. So anytime they called me, they invite me, I always feel happy because it's another time to meet with the people of God and dish out the word of God.
Hallelujah. He said it's always a pleasure coming because it's another time to connect with the people of God. Yes, sir. The theme of our program revival says the destiny makers. Yes. What does God has to say to his people? What does God has to say to his people concerning their destiny? What does God has to say to his people concerning their destiny?
Yes, destiny is a wonderful thing. Everybody in life came into this world with a great destiny. And some people, they don't know how to go about it because enemies have already hijacked their destiny. So it's why a time like this, this team is a wonderful team. It's a time that God will open the eyes of people to know what destiny is all about. Some people don't know what destiny is all about. They feel that, let me come into this world. Anything I see, let me take it like that. But it's not like that. There is purpose you need to accomplish. Because there are some people that their destiny tied to your own destiny. It's why you need to make sure you fulfill destiny in life. And today, by his grace, God is going to open the eyes of people to know more about destiny and know how to pursue their destiny. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, that was a wonderful one, sir. So, sir, moving away from the revival right now, I believe our viewers all over the world would love to know what's a sustaining factor as a pastor. I believe you've been in this ministry, you know, in the work of the Lord for a very long time. So what is that factor that has been sustaining you to still hold on to God despite so many trials, despite so many tribulations? What are those, or what is that sustaining factor that keeps you holding to God?
Well, God is a wonderful God, and God never fails. Whenever trials come, I always tell people why I'm not afraid of anything is that in everything that I'm doing in life, I always create room for failure. And whenever the failure comes, I lock it inside a room and forge ahead. And God remains God. And whenever I look upon God and I know all his promises must surely come to pass, to fulfillment in my life. It's why in trials, in tribulation, I always look up to him.
Thank you so much, sir. God remains God. Doesn't matter the trials or tribulations, God remains God. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, before we go, I would like to ask that, what should the people be expecting from your ministration today? I know so many people, our viewers all over the world, are ready for today's program because yesterday we know for sure would be better. Today would be for sure be better than yesterday. So what should the people be expecting from your ministration today, sir?
They will be expecting the move of God because it's not my work. It's the work of God. And I know whenever, if I mount the pulpit, I'm not the one there again. Holy Spirit will take over. And he knows what to do, and he knows how to do it better. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. So viewers all over the world, you've heard it for our man of God, Pastor Malachi. He's well loaded, he's well prepared. I believe the Holy Spirit is with him right now. We wouldn't love to stress him too much because he needs to get prepared for the service. So before we let you go, sir, your final word to our viewers all over the world, word of encouragement for them to stay away from the telecast. What do you have to say for our viewers all over the world, sir?
God is on the move in every minute of the day. So I will encourage everyone, no matter what you are going through or passing through, the mistake anyone will do in life is to move away from God. Because men and women will fail you. Things that you believe that you will do better may come out the way and you will not, the way you expected it, it may not come in that way. But one thing is that the assurance of God remains. God is not a man that will lie, neither a son of a man that will repent. Whatsoever he say he will do, he will do it. So I encourage every one of us, even including me, that every day, every minute, we need to be in the presence of God. Anything that we are doing in life, we should table it to God, and God will see us through.
Amen. God will see us through indeed in the name of Jesus. So viewers all over the world, you heard it from our man of God, our guest minister for today, Pastor Malachi. It is a wonderful time to have you on our platform. I will pray God bless you in the name of Jesus. So viewers all over the world, stay glued to our telecast. It promises to be a wonderful one. Today, miracles are going to erupt. Testimonies are going to abound. I'm looking forward to seeing Pastor Malachi on the pulpit, dishing out the word of the Lord for you. And I know God of salvation will meet you at the point of your needs in the mighty name of Jesus. So from us here, we're saying to everybody all over the world, to all our Genesis Salvationists all over the world, all our online viewers all over the world, we want to let you know that this is your season for your destiny to manifest. Stay tuned and God bless you. Have a wonderful time out. You're blessed.
Begin to worship God. Thank you for yesterday. Thank you for today. Thank you for tomorrow. Thank you for this week. Thank you for next week. Thank you for this month of October. Thank you for the month of November. Thank you for the month of December. Thank you.
You are bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ìwé orin Dávidi orí ọgọ́rùn-ún.
Psalm 100.
Ìwé orin Dávidi orí ọgọ́rùn-ún.
If you are here, say amen.
Tó bá ti débẹ̀, ṣe àmì.
If you are still sad, say, Pastor, I'm sad.
Tó bá sì wá, sọ pé olùṣàgùtàn, mo sì ń wá ní o.
Amen.
Àmì.
Want to go? Make a joyful shout to the Lord, all you land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gate with thanksgiving, and into his court with praise. Be thankful to him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. And we enter
his gates with thanksgiving in our heart.
I am so glad. I will rejoice.
Amen.
Amen.
I am led to pray for the workers in the house.
Emi Olorun o to si mi pipe ki n gbadura fun awon osise ninu ile.
Workers wherever you are, make sure you are not leaning on the wall.
Gbogbo osise to wa ninu ile e ri pe e farati ogiri.
Technical.
Awon to wa ni imo ero.
Media.
Awon to n gbe wa si afefe.
Vineyard.
Awon to n gba inu ile.
Beautification.
Antonton inu le just se
pastorate
awon olusaguton
elders forum
awon agbagba
music department
gbugbo awon akorin
hospitality
gbugbo awon tin gba ni lalejo
heritage
awon ton ka awon mode wa
workers at the youth church
awon ton je ojise ninu ijo ti awon odo
since church
awon ton je ojise ninu ijo ti awon mo kekere wa.
All workers and ministers in general.
Gbogbo awon osise ninu ile ati awon ton sise ninu
ogba ijara. Hear the word of God from my mouth.
E gbo oro Olorun lati enu mi wa.
The spirit of the living God is upon me.
Emi Olorun Jehovah o wa
lara mi. Because the Lord has anointed me.
Ri pe emi Olorun ti
yomi. To preach good things to the poor.
Lati kede
to preach good tidings to the poor.
Lati mu royin
fun. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound. To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord.
Amen.
And your vengeance of our God.
Amen.
To comfort all who mourn. To console those who mourn in Zion.
Amen.
To give them beauty for ashes.
Amen.
The horn of joy for mourning.
Amen.
The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness.
Amen.
That they may be called trees of righteousness.
Amen.
The planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified.
Amen.
As you are working for God. This same year. The name of God shall be glorifying your life. I was led by the Holy Spirit while in my office. I didn't take it serious. But when I mounted this altar, I received the same message twice. And I have no option than to deliver the message. I emphasize whatever might have making you to groan tonight, God will convert it to your glory. If there is any of you that has been sweating without a result, tonight, sweating without result comes to an end. Your labor of love shall not be in vain. As you are working for the progress of the work of God, the Lord will make your things to work out. As you are ministering to the need of the people in the house of God, may the Lord minister to all your needs. If there is any among us that is small, before the end of this same month of October, that person shall be made big by the power of God. If there is anybody among us who has been waiting upon the Lord concerning certain things, I prophesy, as the man of God mount this altar, the heaven over your new things and good things shall be opened. If there's anything that has pressed you down, by the power of the Most High God, God will destroy them for your sake. And I'm saying this in confidence. You will not die before your time. Right now, I terminate pain. Any sickness or diseases in your body, in your life, by the power of the Holy Ghost, I hereby crush it to death. Samuel worked for God.
Samuel,
and Samuel became a sought after in the land.
Samuel did anytime worry ni nu ile na.
Samuel became the sought after in the whole world. The Bible recorded that the word of Samuel never fell to the ground. From tonight, every word that shall proceed from your mouth shall end in testimony. Through you, the name of the Lord shall be glorified. I hereby pray for everyone here, members and invited guests, including viewers all over the world, by the power and authority of God. 30 is the number of power. Before the end of these 30 days, the Lord will give you power to possess your possession. The Lord will give you power to inherit your inheritance. Anything the enemy has taken away from you, tonight, through the ministration of the man of God, everything, anything in totality shall be restored back to you tonight. Somebody's here. Today marks the end of your shame. Every word of knowledge, word of prophecy that shall proceed from the man of God shall be an accurate one for your sake. As the man of God mounts this altar, every trouble in your life, every pain in your body, every delay and denial in your life, every ridicule, shame and discomfort, every enemy of your progress, tonight they shall die a permanent death. I hereby lift up the man of God before the throne of God. Because of us tonight, and because of viewers all over the world tonight, I saw the man of God in the blood of Jesus. 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 God of Elijah.
Alone with Elijah.
Confirm your servant by fire tonight. Inside him, outside him, around him, let the power of God flow. Almighty God, let your mighty hand rest on him. I speak to the four corners of this city. Right now, I discharge Angel Michael. Go to the north. Go to the south. Go to the east. Go to the west. In the name of Jesus. Tonight, I command heaven of testimonies to be opened. Everybody here tonight shall return home with testimonies. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit.
You are the one.
So okay. Father,
so okay, Baba,
let me witness your power tonight.
Take
open your mouth and talk to God. Father, let me experience your power tonight.
Baba, take riri agbara re ni asale yi.
Let my children experience your power tonight.
Jeki awon omo mi riri agbara re ni asale
yi. Let my business.
Jeki okowo mi.
Let my marriage.
Jeki igbeyawo mi.
Let my career.
Jeki ise osu mi.
Let my body.
Jeki agbara mi.
Everything about me.
O gbogbo nipa mi.
Everything about our church.
O gbogbo nipa ijo
wa. Let it experience your power tonight.
Jeki riri agbara re ni asale yi.
Thank you, Father.
Adupe Baba.
In Jesus mighty name.
Ni oruko lati Jesu ni agbadura.
I am not the man of God tonight. I am not the man of God.
Tonight.
Let us celebrate grace in the house. From what I'm seeing in the spirit realm. From what I am seeing in the spirit realm. I sense it in my spirit that many people here tonight, your letter of testimony shall be put in your hand tonight. Growth in the body will disappear. Things you never expect to happen that will glorify the name of God. God will make it happen tonight. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We are going to dance for the next 20 minutes. Before we invite the man of God,
he's
God's general.
He's a
prophet. I can beat my chest for him. Amen.
Amen.
Make sure you dance very well. I'm seeing Pastor.
Hallelujah.
Pastor, what is it called? Pastor Udeme. I am seeing Mr. Otage. And I'm seeing one woman that lives very close to this church. I'm seeing you sharing testimony. I'm seeing you sharing testimony. So please, even if you don't know how to dance, tonight I will see how Mr. Osage can dance. Just make sure you are shaking your body. Because by the time the man of God take the mic, heaven will move.
Jehovah, 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 Jehovah.
Oh, my God. And I'm going to hallelujah. Awesome.
bottle of soft drink. Including the instrumentalists, including me, including viewers all over the world. Before this time tomorrow, jumbo blessings. Jumbo blessings. Jumbo blessings. In the name of Jesus. The Lord is good. All the time. The atmosphere, the environment is already charged. The hosts of heaven are already set. God's general is overcharged already. Let us celebrate Pastor Yinka Davis. God bless you. I want you to pray just one prayer point before I invite God's servant and interpreter. I want to pray just a simple prayer. Say power to pray and receive testimony. Enter me now. Open your mouth and talk to me. Power to pray and receive testimony.
Agbara lati gbadura ati lati ri eri gba.
Enter me now.
Wonu mi wa.
Power to pray.
Agbara lati gbadura
and receive testimony.
Ati ri eri gba.
Enter me.
Oya wonu mi.
Enter me.
Wonu mi.
Thank you, Father.
Wonu mi.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Lorun lati Jesu ni agbadura.
Amen.
Amen.
Before you have your seat.
Oto joko.
Amen.
Amen.
You have God's servant in the house.
He's
a member of the house.
He's
a family. Presently, he's the president of the Igbo veteran of our church. He carries God's mandate. Evangelistic and prophetic. By the special grace of God Almighty, God has used him in this church more than enough. And tonight, God is ever ready to swallow him. In order for him to vomit God. What you are about to hear is not the man you know. What you
are
about to hear is God Almighty. What you
are
about to see is not the person you know. What you
are
about to see is the transformation of God.
Without
wasting time,
life has to go forever.
Jam your hands together with salvation style of welcome as I invite to the pulpit Pastor Malachi Nnanna. God bless
Malachi.
Praise the Lord.
And you do a logo.
What to two or three people? Tell them that tonight is my night.
Lord, see how doing your magic. Have you met us? Okay, I'll let you. Shall I mean it?
Oh,
have faith in his creature. Wherever you are, begin to appreciate the King of Kings. Begin to appreciate the Lord of Lords. Give him praise. He's worthy to pray. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised. He's the mighty man in battle. Chief Cornerstone. Open your mouth, appreciate him. Appreciate him this evening. He's about to move in your life. He will move in your situation. He will move in your career. He will move in that your problem. Open your mouth. Thank him because he's alive. You are seeing the month of January. We are now in October. Some people are no more. But you are here. It's not by your power. No wonder the Bible says, it's not who that winneth or that runneth. That of him that showeth. God is about to show mercy tonight. Open your mouth and appreciate him. Open your mouth and appreciate him. For the first day. Today is the second day. You will not go home empty. You will go home transformed. You are going to tell it to God tonight. Oh Lord, my Father, make people that will make me. Open your mouth and begin to pray that prayer. Oh Lord, my Father, make people that will make me. Make people that will make me. Make people that will make my family. Make people that will make me. Open your mouth and begin to pray. You can't make yourself. It's only God can make you. Ask God to make people that will make you. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. My sister, come. Bring microphone. Come. God is about to do something in your life and in your family. When I was praying inside, I'm hearing your voice. God call me my son. This is my daughter. And I'm set to do something in her family. Then stand up first. There is a song that you are going to sing just for 2 minutes. And God is going to transform you. You are too faithful to fail me. I want you to sing that song. And let your husband join you.
You are too faithful to fail me. Oh, you are too faithful to disappoint. You've proven yourself in my life.
Mean what you have seen
come to me, your light. You are too faithful to fail me. Jesus, you are too committed to leave me.
Yes, Lord, you are too faithful to fail.
You are too committed to leave me.
You are too proud to bless this one.
Every circumstance you're too faithful.
God have remembered you and your husband. Whatever seemed to be difficult in your life, by the mention of the name that is above every other name, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, is hereby terminated. 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 The action to function, the power to enter into your destiny, receive it now. 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 I enter into the auction of my father in the Lord. Pastor Tony Adesu. I stand in the altar of my father in the Lord. Pastor Tony Adesu. And I speak into your life. Yours shall be possible. Yours shall be possible. People that look down on you before the end of this year, they will look up to you. They say there is any good thing come out from the Lord. Those people that say nothing will come out from your marriage. I stand as God oracle. I prophesy. Unless I'm the one that call myself. Unless this message is from me. Better from the highest. If this message is from the throne of grace. Before the end of this year. Receive the power to flow. Power to flourish. Power for transformation. Power to make it. In the name of Jesus. It is well with you.
And I feel
in Jesus' mighty name with
you. Jesus.
In Jesus. I want you to pray. Say, my father, touch me tonight. Touch my family tonight. Open your mouth and begin to pray that prayer. For in Jesus' mighty name, my sister, starting from this night, every 12 midnight, till 1 o'clock, you and your husband should worship God. You have prayed a lot, you have think a lot, but this time around, worship God for 21 days, you will share testimony. Before the end of these 30 days, you and your husband will share testimony. Praise the Lord. Our God, our Father, we thank you. Baba, I worship you because you are God. I thank you because you never fail. Whenever we call you, you answer us. We are gathered once again. In every meeting, there is a people that you made it for. These are people that you have made for today's meeting. Lord, answer them. Whatever be their heart desires, whatever problem that they come in with, never allow them to go with it. They will lay it at Jesus' feet. And their destiny, you will make it tonight. Baba, you will make their destiny tonight. Lord, cause me to disappear. Appear in my life. Never allow me to speak the word of my own. You have prepared me. Lord, I am here as a messenger to deliver your message. Your message will bring fruit in million folds,
in
billion folds, so shall it be. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Clap your hand as you sit. As a if you are doing it for me or Pastor Tony, it's too big. Give it to God. Give it to God. I say, give it to God. Praise the Lord. I want to appreciate God Almighty for another great opportunity to stand in this altar of my Father in the Lord. It's not that I merit it, but it's the grace of God. I appreciate God. Also, I want to appreciate my father and my mother in the Lord, Pastor Tony Adesuchi. God will take you high. As you are nurturing the destiny of your people, your destiny, your wife's destiny, and your children's destiny, nothing will hurt them. Every one of you will fulfill destiny. I want to appreciate the pastorate and the ministers of the gospel in the house. Because you are in this journey, you will never go halfway. You will accomplish your destiny, and you will. We will meet in heaven in the name of Jesus. I want to appreciate the elders, the deaconess, because you believe in this calling, your own calling. People will believe on it. I want to appreciate every one of you here. You are the reason that we are standing here. You appreciate yourself. Viewers all over the world, appreciate yourself. Appreciate yourself. Appreciate yourself. Without wasting time before we go to prayer, I want to charge us, because this is 30 days of destiny maker. And the only person that can make our destiny is God. It's why I want to charge us in what I title. Don't make yourself. Allow God to make you. Don't make yourself. Allow God to make you. Many people have been making themselves. For years you are created. You have been making yourself. Running from pillar to pole. Nothing to show for. Because last night, I was praying concerning this program. God opened my eyes. I saw meters. Men uncountable. I saw women. Up to 10. They carry it. And they came straight to this altar. And they are sharing it to people. And I pray for you. You will never miss your own. I say you will never miss your own. Don't make yourself. Allow God to make you. We are talking of destiny. We are not talking of marriage. We are not talking of your business. All those things tie in your destiny. It's why you need to take your destiny seriously. Some people will come to church. They will just sit. They want to see others falling. They just want to say, let people see me that I'm a church goer. My brother, my sister, it's not good for you. You need to fulfill destiny. If you are here, always believe God. Always stand in the word of God. Believe in what God will do in your life. Many have been pursuing their destiny by themselves. You are not the creator of their destiny. It's why God tell Jeremiah. He said, before I formed thee, I knew thee. Before you enter into your mother's womb, I have ordained you a prophet. God have destiny what you will be. So you can do it well. It's only God that can do it. It's why you need to allow God to focus and prepare your destiny. It's why you need to allow God to direct your destiny. Some people will say, after all, I am
a full grown man. I am educated. I can face the crowd. I can withstand anything. No, when it comes to destiny, you can't understand the mystery of destiny. Because there is some destiny that you can't fulfill except God step in. Especially the people that carry glorious destiny. No matter what you think that you are today, no matter the level you think that you are operating today, without God you cannot operate far. If God open your eye to show you where he's taking you, you will know that you are nothing. You will know that you are never step. You will know that you are never put any even one step. It's why you need God. I pray for you this night. Heaven will obey your destiny. I say heaven will obey your destiny. Heaven will obey your destiny. In the name of Jesus. God is a destiny maker. No man, no woman that can make destiny. They can only hinder destiny. I pray for you tonight. Whosoever that is hindering your destiny, heaven will terminate them tonight. I say heaven will terminate them tonight. If you allow men to make your destiny, there will be a lot of error. There will be a lot of mistakes. Because they will not make it to be higher than their own. They will want you to be under them so that you will be answerable to them. But I decree, whosoever that is tampering with your destiny, tonight, heaven will terminate them. I say heaven will terminate them. Destiny maker is in the house. He said to make your destiny tonight. He said to make your destiny tonight. You need to release yourself for him to enter into your life. No wonder Jesus said, I'm in the door of your heart. Knocking. If you open, I will come in and fellowship with you. Is Jesus fellowshipping with you? I pray for you tonight. That hardened door. Is your baby open tonight? 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 In the name of Jesus. I want you to follow me. I want to show you in the Bible how men desire people's destiny to be. Some people want to turn your destiny to become a marketplace for them. Some people want to turn your destiny to become a business so that they will benefit from it while you are suffering it. Whosoever that is delaying your destiny, whosoever that is saying that you will not fulfill destiny, tonight the anger of God will meet with them. I said the anger of God will meet with them in the name of Jesus. Turn with me in the book of Acts. Acts
3.
This verse is popular. Everybody knows about it. I read from verse 1. Now Peter and John went up together to the temple at the hour of prayer, the night hour. And a certain man lay from his mother's womb, was carried whom they lay daily at the gate of the temple, which called Beautiful, to ask alms. I pray, whosoever that wants you to ask alms, heaven will destroy them in the name of Jesus. This is a man that God has destined to come out. But from the mother's womb, nothing to write home. People turn the man to favor themselves. They turn the man to become a marketplace. They turn the man to make money from themselves. They lay him in that temple, in that gate. Day and night, the man is there begging. The only thing that they can be able to do is to change the garment of that man. Make sure they give him a good food. But there is no future, no fulfillment of destiny. Whosoever that say you will be feeding from hand to mouth, that you will never fulfill destiny, tonight, heaven will meet with them.
Jesus' name.
begging day and night. They have used the man to build mansion. They are riding cars. But the man is there. They know him as a baker. Nobody knows his right name. Nobody knows what he created for. Nobody knows what he about to do. But the only thing they know is to see the man in the beautiful gates begging for arms. I know somebody's went and saw fear. I said this is the best place to make money. Because people come there every day. People that come to ask from God. That when they are entering, they can see the man and have pity upon him. Whosoever that is pitying you, tonight you will begin to pity them. Some people in Nigeria today, you will see that things is not working well. Any person you ask, he says, is the situation of the country. I pray for you tonight. They will not count you among it in the name of Jesus. Whether situation or no situation, you are not created to be like that. In that land, Isaac saw. And the Bible recorded in hundredfold. He received the same year. Why can't you be Isaac of this generation? Why are you agree with the level of Nigeria? You are not an accidental discharge. You are not created by Nigeria. The Bible says you are wonderful and beautiful man. You are the apple of God's eye. You are a peculiar someone. The holy nation. Don't demote yourself. This man was laying in the beautiful gate. Asking for arms day and night. People are despising him. Nobody can discuss with him. They can only draw and go their way. Whosoever that see you as a draw, tonight heaven is wiping them away. They will be asking you, you are going to church day and night. Nothing to write home. But I pray for you. In these 30 days, you shall be possible. I say, you shall be possible. Whether the devil like it or not, you shall be possible. You shall be possible. You shall be possible. In the name of Jesus. The man is there asking for arms. The people that come in, people will come. They will give him arms. They feel that is where the man belongs to. I don't know where people are thinking that you are belong. Is it in the lower class? Hey, I pray for you tonight. The highest class is where you are going. He was there day and night. I pray for you. Whosoever that say where he kept you, that he will meet you there. Tonight you are going higher. You are going higher. You are going higher. You are going higher. What they normally do for that man is every evening they will come and pick the man. They will say, welcome. You make it today. Don't worry, I'm going to prepare a good food. They don't think of that man's family. That the man need to marry. The man need to bear children. That the man need to do things of his own. The only count of their pocket. I pray whosoever that turns you to his money making venture. Tonight, heaven will reveal them to you. When they come meeting, that your uncle will stand. He begin to boast. And you don't have any mouth. But today, after this ministration, heaven will open your doors. I say, heaven will open your doors. In the name of Jesus. They lay him daily in that gate. Called the beautiful. Asking for arms. Those who entered the temple. Who is he? He see Peter and John about to enter the temple. And he asked for arms. And he fixed eyes on them. With John and Peter. I pray for you. Whosoever that wants you to be fixing eyes in ordinary things. Whosoever that wants you to be fixing your eyes in the way you will be begging. Tonight, heaven will remove you there. Heaven will remove you there. John and Peter said, look at us. So he gave them attention, expecting to receive something from them. Peter said, silver and gold I have none, but what I have, I will give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Wherever they have tied your destiny, I pray tonight you will rise up. I say your destiny will rise up. Your destiny will rise up. Silver and gold I have not. You don't need that money. Peter is telling the man, you don't need that money. You don't need gold. You don't need silver. What you need is freedom. Because they have tied your destiny. Because you cannot move. This is happening in that church. This is happening in the temple. People who get down and receive miracles, signs, and wonders. But you are there begging for arms. You don't need it. What you need to rise up. So your destiny will speak. I don't know where they tie your destiny. But tonight, your destiny will speak. I said tonight your destiny will speak. Tonight your destiny will speak. Silver and gold I have none, but what I have I will give to you. He said in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he didn't end there. He took him. He lifted him. As many that will lift you. As many that will lift your family. As many that will lift your career. As many that will lift your destiny. Tonight they will meet with you. Many people have been entering into that temple. Even men of God, they enter into the temple. Women of God, they enter into the temple. But nobody recognized that man. Nobody is ready to help him. Nobody is ready to lift him up into his destiny. Many people are looking at you. They are waiting the day to mock you. Whosoever that said to mock you, heaven will mock them. I say heaven will mock them. Heaven will mock them. Heaven will mock them. In the name of Jesus. There is somebody that need to wake your destiny. I pray for you tonight. You are going to meet that person. In the name of Jesus. Peter lift him up. And from that day, that man's destiny begin to speak. You are the next. Your destiny will speak. The destiny of your wife will speak. The destiny of your children will speak. The destiny of your husband will speak. In the name of Jesus. You are about to pray. Because there is no time. I want us to write down the reason why God will make you. Reason why God will make you. Number one, he's a creator. He never failed in creation. He's a creator. That man that you are believing on, the day you enter into your mother's womb, you meet the man when you arrive in this earth. But God knows you from your mother's womb. He's your creator. No wonder he said, let's make man our own image. So I write here, he made no mistakes. A man can make a mistake. A woman can make a mistake. But God never make a mistake. He created you. He said, let's make man our own image after our likeness. And he give you the order. Go into the world. Dominate. Refurbish the earth. Be fruitful. So when your destiny is not speaking, you need to run back to your creator. Tonight, as many that will run back to their creator, heaven will answer you in the name of Jesus. Number two, he knows all things. He knows all things. That battle in your life, God knows it. He knows the time it begins. And he knows the time it's going to end. No wonder the Bible says, he knows the end from the beginning. He knows where you are going to. He knows that you will fulfill destiny. The only thing is that God will never show you what you will pass through. He can show you the beginning and show you the end. What you will pass through, you don't know it. It's only Jesus he showed. And immediately Jesus saw it, he was afraid. He said, if it is my own way, let this God pass me over. But according to your way, let your will be done. It's why God can never show you what you will pass through. So what you are passing through or going through today, rejoice, because God must surely fulfill your destiny through you. Unless you run out of track, unless you say, I'm not believing God, let me believe in man, so that I will receive the insult. I pray for you tonight. The God that knows all things, we remember you tonight. I say we remember you tonight. Number three, he is your destiny maker. He is your what? Your destiny maker. Your father cannot make you. Your father is only source that God brought you into this earth. Your mother is the envelope that carried you. But God is your destiny maker. He knows what you will be. He knows where you are going. He knows what you will transform. He knows the people that you are going to help. Even as you are sitting here, God knows what will happen to us in the next minute. Unless what he revealed. If he fail to reveal, it's only what he revealed we can see. Some people will come to church. They want man of God to naked them. It's only what God can show. But when you prepare, God can speak to you. I pray for you tonight. The destiny maker will make you. I said the destiny maker will make you. The fourth one. The heart of kings and the heart of men is in his hand. The heart of kings, the heart of men is in his hand. He turned them at his will. I pray for you. Whosoever that say you will not survive, whosoever that say you will not make it, tonight, they are going down for yourself. I said they are going down for yourself. Haman planned evil concerning Mordecai. But because the heart of king is in God's hands, God turned the heart of King Lazarus to favor Mordecai. Whosoever that have planned, any order that I receive anything concerning your destiny, any order that I receive sacrifice concerning your destiny, concerning your children's destiny, concerning your wife's destiny, tonight they will catch fire. They will catch fire. They will catch fire. Number five, he never fell in battle. God never fell in battle. Where is that battle that is standing before you? No hiding place for any battle. God always see the whole battle. Battle in your family. Battle in the compound you live. Battle in your office. Battle in your business place. Battle in your career. Battle in every way. God sees all. And he can never fail. But let me shock you, nobody sees God. It's only what God can do, people see. It's only what God can do, the enemy see. It's why they can never succeed entering battle with God. It's why they prefer entering battle with you. And when you succumb, they will deal with you. But I pray for you tonight. Heaven is going to wipe them away. He never fell in battle. Number six. He knows the end from the beginning.
That's it, brother.
He knows the end from the beginning.
That's it, brother.
He knows where we are coming from. I pray for you tonight. No wonder the Bible says the latter end is greater than the former. I decree in your life, this part of your life, this remaining months for this year to end, will be greater than the one. It will be greater than from January till now. I say it will be greater than from January till now. In the name of Jesus. Number 7. He knows your needs and your wants. God knows what you need. God knows what you want. I pray for you. Heaven will meet your needs. I say heaven will meet your needs. In the name of Jesus. Finally, he is God. I appreciate him. He is God. He's not a man that will lie. Neither is a son of man that will repent. Whatever he says he will do in your life, he must surely do it. That thing is not happening in your life because you are still struggling. You don't want to release yourself for God to come. You don't want to allow God to make you. You don't want to allow God to make you. You need God to make you. Because when you make yourself, you will be full of mistakes. Let's see 2 Kings. 2 Kings chapter 5. Because of time, we're not going into it much. But Laman is a commander of the army of Syria. He's a great and honorable man. In the eyes of his master. Because the Lord have used him greatly in the land of Syria. Any battle they went into, they always come out victorious. And the master loved him so much, the king can be proud of him.
But
there is a great problem. The destiny is not really fulfilled because he can't associate with people, because people always go back. They don't want him to mingle with them because of all leprosy. I don't know what is in you that makes people to run away. Your destiny helpers is running away from you. I don't know what the enemy have attached in your life that makes your destiny helpers to run away. Tonight, heaven will consume them by fire. They will go to war and they will win. Others will be in the palace celebrating with the king. They will toast in there, but they will package his own food. After battle, he will enter into his corner. I know he's not happy. I don't know how many people that is here tonight, that the situation you are now, you're not happy about it. But I have a good news for you. After this 30 days, you will be speaking where the grains and
beans
are. That office that you cannot be able to enter, as you are coming, they will open door. They will break protocol because of you. They can only remember Lema. Whenever there is war, and I know they will wrap him because nobody wants to contact that leprosy. They cannot hug him, even though if they are winning in the war. They can only give him high five. They can only give him thumbprint. They can only thumbprint him. After everything, people will went to the king and begin to say, we have survived. Haman will be hearing their voice. Haman will be seeing them celebrating. But it's not there. I don't know where they have exempt you. The place you're supposed to be, that you are not operating there. After tonight, you will begin to operate there. But the destiny maker remember Haman. They remember Haman. That night, the mistress that they brought into their country that is waiting upon his wife. He discussed with his wife. Some people that despise people. When somebody come around, you say, you are not my class. I don't need to discuss with you. You don't know who will obey your destiny. You are not belong to our class. I don't want to talk to you. Which university do you pass at? Which level is it? I pray for you. Tonight, heaven will change your mind. Some will say, I'm a first class
lady.
Are you a first class or second class?
But
the woman calm down. He mingle with that lady. And the lady, they begin to discuss. He said, people have been despising your husband. But there is a place that your husband will enter. No one will despise him again. Your husband needs to see my prophet. I pray for you tonight. Because you are in this auction. You will excel. You will excel. You will excel. Amen. Quickly rush to his master. He break the news. The master said, okay, I will send you to the land of Israel. I know the king. The king is my captive. But I allow him there to reign. Take this letter to the king. But I pray for you. That man, that woman that will make your destiny. Tonight you are meeting with them. I said, tonight you are meeting with them. Through the help of that lady, Haman entered into the river. River Jordan for 7 times. And he was made whole. The destiny speak full. I don't know where your destiny is speaking
for.
I don't know where your destiny is speaking for. Tonight, your destiny is speaking
for.
I say your destiny is speaking
for.
There is a woman. This woman went to hospital. And the doctor told the woman, you have fibroid. And you need to operate it. Without operation, you cannot conceive. The woman said, how much is it going to cost? He said, it's going to cost
250,000.
The woman said, okay, I will come back. The woman went home and gathered 250,000. I pray for you tonight because of your faith. Your destiny will spare. The woman gathered 250,000. He said, I'm not going back to that hospital. He carried the 250,000. Lay it in the altar of God. He said, Father, no physician is greater than you. The doctor have given their report. And this is the money that they charge me. I bring it to you. Operate me. After the woman prayed, the woman went home. After 1 month, he decided to visit that hospital again. When the doctor checked the woman, he said, madam, which hospital that operates you? Because I can't see any razor. Which surgeon is that carry out this assignment? The woman says, is God. I pray for you. The God of destiny. The God that make you. The God that call Pastor Tonya Desuji. We meet you tonight. We meet you tonight. We meet you tonight. Tonight, your destiny must surely speak. In concluding, before we pray, anyone that doesn't know you better will never do better in your life. Nobody knows you better except God. Your wife don't know you better. Your husband don't know you better. They can only call you honey. You can believe that you know your husband better or your wife better. Nobody knows you better except God. It's why God is going to obey your destiny tonight. He's going to repair your destiny. He's going to repair your destiny. He's going to repair your destiny. If you believe God, that is going to repair your destiny, jump up on your feet. We're going to pray.
I
want you to pray tonight. I want you to shout, my Father, my God. My Father, my God, attend to my destiny. Open your mouth and begin to pray that prayer. My Father, my God, attend to my destiny. Attend to my destiny. Attend to my destiny. Open your mouth and begin to pray. My Father, my God, attend to my destiny. Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want you to pray. Whatever it will cost you for my destiny to speak, do it now. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Whatever it will cost you. Whatever it will cost you. For my destiny to speak. Whatever it will cost you. For the destiny of my children to speak. Whatever it will cost you. For the destiny of my wife to speak. Whatever it will cost you. For everything around me to speak. Do it tonight. 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 Jesus mighty name we pray. Before I will drop this mic, I want to, God asked me to pray for these three categories. Number one, you are here, you are looking for a job. Or you are a contractor, no contract. Walk to the altar. You want to change your job. Walk to the altar. You are looking for a job. You are a contractor. You need a contract. Remember me, O Lord. Remember me, O Lord. Remember me, O Lord. I pray.
I pray.
You are looking for a job. You want to change your job. Or your contract is not bringing
forth.
Tonight, heaven will turn things around for you. I say, heaven will turn things around for you. Heaven will turn things around for you. Heaven will turn things around for you. Wherever you submit your CV from today, you will call up. Wherever you submit your CV, they will call you in the name of Jesus. Wherever you submit your proposal, I pray you will win the contract. You will win the contract. Power to make it. Receive it now. 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 In the name of Jesus.
So shall it be.
Ben, you're
for in Jesus' mighty name.
You're Jesus, you're
from today, go and photocopy your CV.
That
photocopy that your contract.
Hello, papers.
Be coming with it. You must surely share testimony.
The
second people, the people that is looking for the fruit of womb. If you know you are looking for the fruit of womb, because this altar I stand is the altar of my Father and the Lord. By His grace, He is fruitful. And me that is standing here, I'm fruitful. He born twins, I born twins. And I pray for you tonight. Twins will enter you. I said twins will enter you. Hannah cried to God. Because my Bible tells me there is no barrel in the land except the wife of David. Because he wanted to mock God. It's the only woman that is barrel. I pray for you. Tonight, the angel that visited Mary is still available. Tonight he will pay you a visit. Anything that seems to be hard, anywhere that is blocked, I command, they will be open tonight in the name of Jesus. Receive fruitfulness. Receive fruitfulness. Receive fruitfulness. Receive fruitfulness. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Last people, you are here. You always dream bad dreams. Whenever good things is coming on your way, you will be in the dream. After that bad dream, that thing will not come again. Come outside. Whenever you're expecting things, when you dream, that thing will not come to pass. Come outside. I pray for you tonight. After tonight. After tonight. Those evil dreams. Those dreams that hinder your progress. Is hereby be destroyed. I say, is hereby be destroyed. Is hereby be destroyed. Every evil dream that the enemy has used to attack you. When good thing, when you're expecting good things, immediately you dream, those things will begin to linger. I prophesy in your life. Tonight, that chain is broken. I said, that chain is broken. That chain is broken. That chain is broken. That chain is broken. And from today, atmosphere of miracle. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. So shall it be. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Two more prayer points. I will drop this mic. I want you to pray tonight. My Father, my Father. Before the end of the 10 days of this program, I will be the first to testify. Open your mouth and begin to pray that prayer. Before the first 10 days of this program, I will be the first to testify. I will be the first to testify. I will be the first to testify. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and begin to pray. You will testify. You will testify. You will testify. You will testify. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Send my destiny helper. Wherever you are, locate me by fire. Open your mouth and begin to pray. My destiny helper. Wherever you are, locate me by fire. Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Just to Niagbadura.
Before we pray for you people, don't be tired of giving. Before, you must
Go extra mile before your destiny will speak.
Let me tell you the truth.
The Shalamite woman, the first thing that the woman did, he began to feed the man of God. He turned it to become a daily thing. From there, he asked the husband, let's build an tent. That giving you are giving today is waiting for you tomorrow. That woman never know that that house, that penthouse that he built, he will need it. But when he's building it, he never know that a day will come that he will need it. When they call for seed, many people will sit down. It's for your own good. You can't come for a program like this and you cannot be able to testify. Let me tell you, you are in this church that they run program day and night. You're supposed to prosper. This early morning, as I was praying, God told me something concerning the man of God. He said he had finished the work. It's time for him to
agree.
All prayer that he's praying now is not for his own. It's for us. And you need to do your own part. To do what? To click. And I pray for you. God will open your eyes. In the name of Jesus. The Shalamite woman graduate. He never go down. He never say, today there is no food. If it is putting one meat, he increase it to two meats. From there, he build a place. He put a bed. He put a lamp. So that the man of God will feel comfortable. But they take care. The man of God enter there. He say, he called Gehazi. He said, this woman has been doing a great thing for us. What do you think that we can do to this woman? Gehazi said, we have been coming here. After all, we have come from January to December. During the time of fix. During the time of December. During the time that school have closed. I never noticed any kind of thing that children is in this house. Even if they are in school, there is a time that they will close. Even if they are anywhere, if they are working, there is a time that they will come home. But nothing like that.
So
he said, call the woman. He said, by this time, let's say you embrace a son. You are here, you are telling yourself, I will not tire of giving. I don't want to mention money. If you know what you will use to open your destiny, I want you to run to the altar. With it, anything that you are convincing your heart, say, God, I want to use this thing to open my destiny. Come to altar. I want to pray with you. Come to altar. If you don't have it today, you can bring it tomorrow.
Any,
I don't want to mention amount. Anything that you say, God, I want to use this to open my destiny. I want to use this to open my destiny. Come to the altar. I cannot do without you. I cannot do without you. I cannot do without you. Oh Lord.
in the name of Jesus. Whosoever that water shall be water. Your children is out to water. Baba, water them back. Lord, water them back.
Lord,
water them back. They are not tired of giving. Lord, open their doors. Let their destinies speak. Between 9 to 10 days. Let their destinies speak. Between 9 to 10 days. Let their destinies speak. Somebody is here.
And they can be.
Between now, you will be among the people that will share first testimony. I don't know how God is going to do it. But I'm hearing it. And I perceive it clearly. Somebody is in the
air.
You will follow among the people that will testify. In the first 10 days. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. I pray for you. That money you are going to draw. A million folds. Before this month runs out, in a miraculous way, he will enter your hand. He will enter your hand. Somebody will transfer money into your account. Alarmic alert will locate you. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. If you have your phone, you can drop it.
Give you
time by tomorrow. My brother, come. My papa. The God that changed the destiny of Jabez. Tonight, you will change your destiny. Jabez carried a glorious destiny. But the mother called him Jabez. Because he
bear
Jabez in pain. Maybe the man that pregnanted her abandoned her. He decided to curse the child. But Jabez said, no. You can curse me as a mother. But God never cursed me. You can despise me as a mother. But I know the God that I serve. I heard what God did in the land of Egypt. I heard how God opened the way. In the wilderness. We never know there is a bridge in the Red Sea until the day that God commissioned it. I prophesy in your life. Nothing that God needs to commission in your life. This day, heaven will commission it. Heaven will commission it. Heaven will commission it. Heaven will commission it. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be. I said here, I want you to shout seven prophetic hallelujah. One, two, go.
Hallelujah, make you yell. Hallelujah.
Glory. Ogo. Stretch your hands towards God's servants.
And I want you to see you show Lord Allah.
While he was ministering.
That one was you.
I felt God's presence. And I was surprised when our mother and the Lord also confirmed the same thing. She said, Pastor, I felt God's presence.
Baba wa ninu Oluwa awon ri wa laye Olorun.
We pray for you, man of God.
Agbadura fun yin ojuse Olorun.
May the gift of God upon your life never depart.
Emi Olorun ninu aye yin ko ni fi yin sile.
May the Lord wash you clean.
Ki Olorun ko tun bo fo yin mo.
Impart unto you the spirit of purity.
Ko gbewo yin emi mimo.
Sanity.
Emi otito.
Sanctity.
Emi to pe.
May you grow from grace to grace.
Yeah, receive that back.
As for you, your wife and children, it is well.
As
for you, your ministry, it is well.
The
Lord catapult your calling to the mountain top.
Mountain
top of glorification.
Okay, love in the name of God the Father, Lord God, Baba,
Son and the Holy Spirit.
You
are blessed. Let us celebrate grace, please. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Adupe Jesu.
Destiny maker, you are the destiny,
destiny maker. Oh, come and make my destiny today. Come and make my destiny today.
Close your eyes, we are about to go.
Di oju re asetan lati lo bayi.
Your original destiny from heaven.
Ayanmo re ogidi lati orun wa.
That the enemy has tampered with.
Ti ota ti bowolu.
That problems of life has covered.
Ti isoro aye yi ti gbo mole.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Oruko Jesu Christ ti Nazareti.
I prophesy upon your original destiny.
Moso aso tele lori ogidi ayanmo re.
At the shout of your three powerful amen.
Moso ma se amen meta.
In the name of Jesus.
Loruko Jesu.
Let your original destiny manifest.
Ki ogidi ayanmo re ko fara won.
That man or woman that God has prepared for you.
Okunrin abi obirin ti Olorun ti pese sile fun o.
As you set out this week, even if you refuse to go out this week,
peradventure
your annual leave commence tomorrow morning. Anyhow you choose to live your life from tonight, your destiny maker will locate you. God is our guarantor.
Olorun ni oluduro wa.
I pray for everyone here.
O gbadu afun gbogbo eyan to wa nibi.
Most especially you that you used to see yourself doing well in the dream.
Abi wo to ma ri ara re pe o se daada loju ala.
But in reality you are not doing well.
Sumo loju aye o se daada.
The man of God has spoken and God has spoken.
From
tonight,
may
you begin to do well.
Amen. Amen.
I want to do something prophetically now. Pastor Inka Davis, come. Pastor Malachi, come. Please put your hand on my shoulder. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. From this moment, whoever the Lord has mandated to help you, from tonight, that person will not be able to sleep well. Listen and listen really good. I speak to the four corners of the whole world. To as many that believe it, including viewers all over the world, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that man in that embassy, that lady in that embassy, that politician at Aso Rock, that politician at Lagos House,
that senator, that honorable, that CEO, that man, that woman, that auntie, that uncle, male or female, home and abroad, that the Lord has mandated to raise you up from tonight until they help you, they shall be restless. By the order of the mountain of transfiguration, Moses appear.
Moses Pharaoh.
Elijah appear.
Elijah Pharaoh.
Hey! Your destiny helpers.
I want to man run your mother lower.
Within the next 72 hours.
Larry or Jometa.
Whether the devil like it or not, whether you believe it or not, God will compel them to appear. Your money in the hand of stingy people. That man demanding for sex before he will assist you. That man making unnecessary condition before he will assist you. If you are called by God before the end of this week, by fire by force, your portion shall be released. When Tinubu was speak, many people rejected him. When Fasola was speak, many people rejected him. When Ambode was speak, many people rejected him. By the order of the book of Esther, chapter 2, verse 1 to 17. The scripture recorded that many virgins were arranged before the king. But look at the mystery of life. Esther, a strange lady in a strange land. I am not a Lagosian. I am a stranger in this land. I don't know about you. If you are a Lagosian, I see a vision for you. In this very Lagos, yours shall be possible. Lagos is known as the center of excellence. There are spirits, there are excellent spirits. There are money, there are excellent money. There are progress, there are excellent progress. I speak over your life. I prophesy upon your destiny. From tonight, your destiny shall no longer misbehave.
I don't know what it's going to take from God. I don't know what it's going to cost God.
Because your destiny is crying for help. Within the next 72 hours, help from above will locate your destiny. There are some parents here, your concern is your child. The Lord is speaking expressly to you now. Between now and November
30,
over that child, testimony will come. In the name of Jesus. I am confident of the call of God upon Pastor Yinka Davis. I am confident of the call of God upon Pastor Malachi. I am confident of the call of God upon my life. Of the truth, we are not perfect. Of the truth, we are not saints. But by grace, we are chosen. Now listen to me. From tonight, I remove disgrace from your life. Be removed. In the name of name of Jesus. The Lord said I should announce to his children, since you have been waiting for now, the Lord said I shall announce to the church that from now they are being released. Receive your home. Receive your home. Receive your home. In the name of Jesus. It is done. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. Package your offering. Prophesy upon it.
So
please remember not to fight. Remember not to get angry. To obey is better than sacrifice. 30 days is not too much for you to be sober.
Please,
God has prepared this wonderful man of God. God has prepared this wonderful man of God for our
good.
What Pastor Malachi told Brother Rotimi, I told him in the morning. And truly, it will be great. In Jesus' name. You too shall be great.
And you know, Adinla.
In Jesus' name. Raise it up, say, Father. As I drop this for your kingdom, Father,
Baba,
make me a kingmaker.
Jack in there,
make me a destiny maker. Worldwide, in Jesus' name. Drop it, God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. It's time to go. We appreciate your patience. When you get home, eat little eba or apple. Don't be too heavy. Amen. You can drink water before 12 midnight. After 12 midnight, before you can put anything in your mouth, it's 12
noon.
Just 12 hours. Just to humble us. And tomorrow morning, tomorrow evening, wow, it's going to be powerful. Oh God, it's going to be powerful. Don't miss it. Do the work of an evangelist. Invite as many as possible. As you are doing this, the Lord will blow your business. The Lord will catapult it to places worldwide. In the name of Jesus. Ah, I thought all of you would say amen to that. Everything you represent, everything that represents you shall go places. In the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for the interpreter, fresh auction, fresh oil, fresh fire, anointing for possibilities in all aspects of his life. Your family is blessed. Your ministry and calling is blessed. In Jesus' mighty name. It is time to go. Thank you, Father. Amen. The grace in fellowship, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with us now and forevermore. Surely, God's goodness and mercy will follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell now to the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Seven powerful hallelujah. One, two, go.
Hallelujah.
One,
hallelujah.
Two,
hallelujah.
Three,
hallelujah.
Four,
hallelujah.
Five,
hallelujah.
Six,
hallelujah.
God bless you. Have a wonderful
day.
welcome. How was today's service, sir?
It was awesome.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So what did you enjoy about the service?
Everything. A new beginning, a new insight about testimony of God. I've been reading that place you read about
the man that was lame and about Naaman. But today, God, through the man of God, gave us a new insight. Like what happened, that it is only God that can turn around destiny. Amen.
Hallelujah. Viewers at home, I hope you can listen to what my brother said. He said he had a new insight on the Bible verse we've been reading all this while. To God be the glory. Thank you so much, sir. And we look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Are we expecting to see
God
you tomorrow?
God will help me out to complete the 28 days.
All right. It is well with you. Thank you very much, sir. All right. I have with me, I have someone else here with me. I have with me, sister. Can we please meet you, ma?
I'm telling that you're here with me.
Did you attend yesterday's program? Okay, boy, how was today's program?
It was awesome.
What did you enjoy most about the program?
I enjoyed the prayer session and the word of God.
Okay, I'm looking forward to seeing you tomorrow. Should we be expecting you?
Sure.
All right. Thank you so much. Viewers all over the house, thank you so much. And I believe you people were also, you also received miracles. You also, you know, connected to the program and you also attached yourself to it. I expect that viewers at home were connected and I'm sure that your testimony is going to manifest in the name of Jesus. Tomorrow is another day to be in God's presence, and I know tomorrow will be better and greater than today, and I can't wait to see you. And don't forget, this is the season for your destiny to manifest. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Have a wonderful night's rest. You are great.
Amen.